Now, at this point, I would be going on to what you wanted to do, except Miss Margaret told me, and I'm looking at the whiteboard, that you all had worked on a particular problem with ocelots and warblers.
Warblers.
Is that right? I had
yes.
to say it.
Yes.
Okay. And so, and I think you all got the answer, but we're, and you did it manually, and by the way, I just love your manual graphs, by the way. I just think they're gorgeous. And I am one of these that everybody has to graph.
So much.
Everybody has to graph manually first, but then it's kind of nice to have the calculator to see if you know, perhaps got your answer correctly. Okay. Now, and what I'm going to show you, Miss Margaret thought she was saying, "Oh yes, show them that that." Forgot what her words were, but that kind of hard way.
System of equations.
That doing an intersection,
yeah.
But actually, when you have two lines, and okay. Let's think about it for a moment. I know you already know the answer, but if you have two lines, there are possibilities, just like the parabola and the straight line. If you have two lines, they might not intersect at all. Do you know what that case would be? If two lines?
If they're parallel.
If they're parallel, your two lines really weren't parallel. But if they were, they would not intersect, so you would not have an intersection. Okay. There is another case where if you had two equations and you had infinitely many points of intersection. When could that happen?
If it was just one line.
It was exactly the same line. They were just, you know, they tried to disguise it a little bit. Maybe they said y equals x plus 2 and y equals 2x plus 4, and they were real, that's really the same. 2y equals 2x plus 4. In other words, they just went through and did a quick little multiplication to try to fool you, but it was really the same line. Okay.
Or one's written in standard, one's written in slope.
Exactly. You could have slope-intercept form and another one in standard form. Just whatever way that they tried to kind of make you not think they were the same line. But what's the most common thing when you have two lines they intersect in? 3 points? 2 points? 5 points? Two lines. If you have two lines and they are not parallel and they're not the same line.
It's okay.
Do you know, Casey?
1 point.
They're going to intersect at 1 point. One and only 1 point. Exactly. And you all got some answer the other day. Okay. So we're going to just confirm what you got. Does everybody remember what you got?
It was this morning, so yes.
Oh, yes, that was right before I came in or whatever. Okay, so what do you remember what you got for your intersection point? Because that's your solution. The solution is
12, 10.
Yes.
12, 10. Okay, so let's just go ahead and do that because we learned how to do it just a few minutes ago or maybe an hour ago, whatever. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to go back to our y equals. And we're going to clear what we've got out there. So clear your first equation, arrow down on your TI-84 and clear out the second equation. All that wonderful work is gone. Okay. And then arrow back up until you're right by Y1 equals and you're ready for... Okay. Are you back up to Y? Okay. Oops, gosh, I'm sorry, I keep bumping into these tables. All right, okay. So now this was the first one. Now, I think Miss Margaret gave it to you as x plus y equals 22, but then you went ahead and solved it for y equals negative x plus 22. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So it's, what kind of slope does it have? Think about that invisibility stuff.
It's 1.
But it said negative x, so.
Sorry,
negative 1. Okay. So it's going to have a negative slope. All right. Let's see if we know how to enter this. We have to be very careful. I said negative, which one of these buttons, even though it's going to say minus, which one is really the negative
button?
It's
the one on the bottom corner.
Okay. All right. So that's what we have to push. Even though it says minus, that's the negative one. If we press the minus as an operation, like add, subtract, multiply, or divide, it will give us an error message. So we have to do the right one. Then find your variable, your x, whatever you want to call that button. And then we have plus 22.
Plus
22.
Two.
Okay. So everybody got negative x plus 22. These screens are hard to see, especially upside down. It's even worse.
I was playing around on my calculator, and I found an option that you can zoom in with your screen.
Oh, yes, there is a zoom in. Yes. We're going to do a little something in just a moment. We're not going to do that, but we are going to do something because of what's about to happen to us. But I don't want to tell us ahead. Okay. Well, arrow down. And we're going to put in the second equation. It started out as 4x plus 2y equals 68. Then you went ahead and subtracted 4x from both sides. And then you divided by 2 and you got y equals negative 2x plus 34. So go ahead and put that in for your second equation. Don't forget your negative. It's the right side would just be negative 2x plus 34.
Hold on.
Plus.
Oh, you have a three there.
I just deleted it.
No,
it's
still there. No, you have to have your cursor on the 3 for it to delete it.
Okay, now. So it's negative 2x plus 34. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Good. 34.
And what kind of slope does that have?
It's a two.
What about that negative?
Negative 2.
It's negative 2. And so it's going in a what direction also, like the first one?
It's
downward. Oh, okay. Well, you know that. You graphed that earlier. Okay. Now, we just want to graph them. So what do we do?
Trace.
Press trace. You're going to hear it plotting all those points.
What?
Okay, now I am presuming that Miss Margaret, I'm presuming that your window is the standard that we usually start with, which is negative 10 to positive 10 on the x-axis and negative 10 to positive 10 on the y-axis. Okay, so I've got to teach you something that's not on the cheat sheet.
I knew something like that.
Okay, because right now what we have is we have this beautiful coordinate plane with nothing on it. Okay, so everybody, don't do anything yet. We've got to find window. And window is in that row, is just below the screen, and it's the second one. So press window. Now, can somebody tell me what was your smallest x value? It wasn't negative 10. Do you remember it? I have the data table that Miss Margaret gave me, but do y'all remember what the smallest x value you used was?
Would be the smallest number of oscillates that I might have had.
Zero.
Okay. So what you're going to do is right where you are, just push zero and arrow down.
I think I moved my arrow, so I'm not really sure.
You're in the right place.
So just put zero?
Zero, and then arrow down on your TI-84. X max. Okay, do you remember the largest number of oscillates that you had?
22.
Okay, so put 22 for that.
Good.
Everybody's tutuing? Okay. And then the next, we're just moving past that. That's just, you know, basically the scale is just one. We're not going to change our scale. And then go down to where it says Y min. Now, I did notice that you did have a negative.
We didn't graph it.
Do you want to graph what, or do you want to, what do you want to put for your Y min? You don't, would you have a negative number of oscillates?
No.
Is it realistic that you would have you would have any negative ones?
No.
So let's just go ahead and make that what? What do you think the farthest you went down?
Zero.
About zero? Okay. I don't even think you went to zero, but let's go ahead and put zero there. Yeah, you just put zero and arrow down, and that's what it does. It replaces it. And then arrow down, and Y max is 10. And what was your max of Y, that your maximum Y value?
It was 34.
34? So we're going to need to put 34 in there.
You can use 34, but I mean, Y is the number of workers, and you couldn't have had any more than 22.
But the problem is that the window that we had before wouldn't contain any of our points. It was our window was in that little corner down there that had nothing in it. Okay. And then we're gonna go ahead and press. I'm just gonna press trace again because it will actually graph it for us.
If you can see it, watch it graph.
Oh my.
like my board moves.
Sounds like a siren.
Okay, now that one was with the slope of negative 1. Now I want you to press the either the up or down arrow to go to the other graph. And listen to that. Listen to the difference.
Can't we do
and you have,
yes,
you have yes. to do the yes, shift. Hold the dot 6 and then press 4.
Can you listen to this real quick?
Oh, wait a minute. Yes. What happened to your... Uh-oh. Okay, let me tell you what happened. All righty. Something happened to your plus sign, and so you had... You had a very weird graph. Okay.
Can I see it?
Oh, well, I already fixed it.
That'd be a really good thing.
You had graphed y equals 2x34. So I don't know exactly.
You didn't.
Okay. Well, now it's okay.
Can I hear it?
Okay. But can y'all tell me the difference between the two graphs?
Can I hear it?
Yes. Okay. That's a little listen. Okay. All right. Out of preference. Out of preference. Okay. Now you've got to hold. This time you have to hold the shift key. Okay.
Okay.
And then I wish it wasn't that long.
And then.
Okay. Now try the other one. I want you to hear the difference. Okay. Then. So just go ahead and play. Can you tell that's steep? I mean, it's going down
yes.
faster.
Yes.
Okay, now.
It started higher
and then it's going. Okay, well, I just want to make sure that you kind of got an idea of what this looks like.
I think
okay.
you'd make a really good ring.
Okay, yeah, now, I'm going to see if you learned anything. What we want to find the intersection, because that's really what Miss Margaret has asked us to do. So how do we find intersections?
Oh, yeah.
Very good.
Calculate,
intersect. Very good, Todd. Can you press enter? And you're going to, guess what? We have one point of intersection, so guess what? All we have to do is say, we're on the first curve, say yes. Say yes. Yes, say yes again.
Wait, what do we do?
You just say yes to first curve, yes to second curve, and yes to guess. So it's really nice when you have two linear equations. So Miss Margaret, I thought you would be happy
yes.
to know. When I do the parabola, you know, or something worse, I mean, not worse,
yes.
but a little more difficult, it gets harder. But when you just do a system of two linear equations.
That's
it's
easy.
It is.
Can you
very
get
nice.
Two parabolas on this graph?
We could do a whole bunch, but we don't have time to do everything.